Now we move on to supercells. Some of your most violent, severe weather will occur from them. Your severe weather threat level is high for pretty much any type of severe weather that goes along with it. Supercells are responsible for the most significant tornadoes and hail that occur. They also can produce extreme high winds and flash flooding. There are two types of supercells that we will look at. The first one is referred to as a classic supercell. These are the ones that have potential for long-track tornadoes that stretch for at least 10 miles or so. Typically, they will be easier to see. The one you'll be more likely to see around here, though, is referred to as a high precipitation supercell. Typically in these, the rotation is hidden by the heavy rain that occurs. These are very dangerous to spot. Both types of supercells are very organized and they produce long-lived storms. This is due to the high instability and wind shear that is present. They produce a high threat to life and property. Within the storms, the updrafts will rotate. This only occurs in supercells. The rotating updraft is also referred to as a mesocyclone. This is what specifically we are seeing on radar in terms of velocity imagery, the rotating updraft within a storm. Within both classic and high precipitation supercells, you can see the spiral bands rotating around them. This is a clue that the updraft is rotating. Look for a wall cloud. This is a persistent lowering near the updraft. This is also referred to as a rain-free base that's underneath it. Usually these are long-lived. The key to it is noting the rotation. Upward motion is often present when you're visually spotting these storms. Wall clouds may also have what we call a tail cloud, which points back toward the heavy rain. Here are a few different examples of wall clouds and funnel clouds. In this particular example, a funnel cloud did develop and was followed by a brief tornado. However, in this particular example, the wall cloud did not produce a tornado. This particular storm occurred across northern Illinois a few years ago and produced an EF4 tornado. The radar presentation is basically a textbook case of what we would look for. We have a hook echo located within the circle, and within that hook echo is high reflectivity caused by debris being lofted up from the tornado. When you're spotting classic supercells, watch for a clearing area near the wall cloud and the developing funnel. This is referred to as a rear flank downdraft, or RFD, and is also known as a clear slot. Also watch for rotation and dust at the ground and a connection to the wall cloud. That is the beginning of a tornado. In this particular image, the connection isn't quite there yet, but by 2 minutes later, you see the dust being kicked up from the ground. The mature stage of a tornado is the most dangerous stage. The debris that is occurring may hide the fact that it is still in contact with the ground. This particular image shows that the debris being kicked up quite a ways, and you can't really see the point of the tornado touching the ground. As you go further along and the storm starts to weaken, this is referred to as the dissipating or rope stage. It may be smaller, but it still has strong wind speeds. Be sure to watch out for another tornado to develop within a few miles. Here is an example of what we call a cyclic supercell. The main tornado is visible in the middle of the screen there. As we zoom in, a couple minutes later, there is a funnel cloud that's forming to the right of the main tornado. We see the development of the new tornado as the old one starts to weaken. With a high precipitation or HP supercell, these are much more difficult to spot. In this particular example, you can see the heavy rain that is occurring underneath the mesocyclone. Usually the south areas of the storm is the best place for you to be stationed. However, in this particular location, you can't usually see the lowest rotation because it is obscured by the rain. If you happen to see the rotation, you probably are not in the best location. The rain is wrapping into the tornado, and the storm is moving toward you. When watching on radar, one of the things to look for is what we call a notch that's in the front of the storm. Usually, the tornadoes are located in this particular area. However, this is not always the case. This particular example, from a tornado that occurred near Gifford, Illinois, in November of 2013, the notch would appear to be right over Gifford at the time of the radar image. However, if you were to look at the actual velocity part of the radar image, you will notice that the mesocyclone is still several miles to the southwest. Since with HP supercells, it is very difficult, if not impossible, to see the rotation through the rain, you need to be extra careful.